Via Coney tracking what else is in our atmosphere this morning.
Thanks so much, John and Brittany. And we are seeing some drizzle along with some widespread fog, especially around the Pikes Peak region, portions of Highway 24 and Woodland Park. This is a live view from our Pikes Peak Summit House Neighborhood Weather Network camera. 33 degrees. It's chilly at the top of Pikes Peak. And keep in mind that it will be chilly in the lower elevations this morning as well with those widespread clouds. Also some blustery conditions this afternoon and some showers. So overall, it's going to be cool and cloudy. Now to that visibility issue that we're dealing with right now. Very limited along portions of the I-25 corridor for Leadville, Denver through Burlington, portions of the Eastern Plains. Use your low beam headlights. Give yourself plenty of room between you and the driver ahead of you and a couple extra minutes to get into work. We don't want you rushing this morning. We want to make sure that your safety is really maintained this morning. Right now, temperatures in the 50s and 60s for the I-25 corridor. Northern El Paso County currently ranges in the 50s with 40s for Manitou Springs, 54 right now for I-25 at Garden of the Gods, with 49 for Westcliff. Pueblo West currently sitting in the upper 50s, Walsenburg and Trinidad in the mid to upper 50s. High temperatures, I mentioned it earlier, will be cooler than normal. 60s and 70s for the I-25 corridor. It won't feel like July in the Eastern Plains as well, with some of the upper 70s possible. 50s through the 70s for the mountains and the valleys. Live HD Doppler radar isn't indicating any sort of activity, just a few showers for the mountains, spotty showers elsewhere. But remember that that drizzle is just too light for Doppler to really pick up, but we are still seeing that in some spots, and it's creating some wet roads, and that's just going to be something else that will slow you down. This afternoon, we'll add in that possibility for even stronger storms, capable of producing some heavy rains and hail. Here's a look at rain accumulations by tomorrow morning. Some of that rain expected to be focused for Alamosa. Anywhere between a trace to a tenth of an inch for Colorado Springs and Pueblo, and almost a third of an inch possible for the southern portion of the I-25 corridor. Stick with us throughout the day. We'll keep you ahead of the storms. 8:30, still dealing with a lot of clouds to go around. I'm saying this fog should dissipate sometime after 9 o'clock, especially for the Pikes Peak region. A quarter before 11, take a look. These showers and storms build in the mountains and increase in intensity and in coverage. A quarter before noon shows that a few of these showers and storms could impact the Walsenburg area, but elsewhere along the interstate, staying pretty dry. It won't be until later this afternoon when the Palmer Divide will start to see some of these showers and storms. Just a quarter before 3, almost starting to creep in. The storm starting to creep in. A quarter before 5, still Colorado Springs and Pueblo staying pretty dry, but the southern portion of the I-25 corridor expected to see those showers and storms. I'm saying it won't be until between 5 and 9 o'clock when the Colorado Springs Pueblo area will start to see some of these showers and storms. This activity should dissipate right around 9 to 10 o'clock. 7-day forecast shows that we will be boosting those temperatures to the mid to upper 70s Wednesday and Thursday. A very active weather scene, though, is anticipated. Spotty showers expected Friday all the way through Sunday. So over the weekend, it should be decent for getting outside, going camping, enjoying southern Colorado. But be aware of the possibility for some afternoon showers and thunderstorms, especially in the mountains. In Pueblo, we're keeping the chance for these showers all the way through Thursday. Make sure you're weather aware all the way up until then. We'll be keeping an eye on the weekend. By Friday, those temperatures expected to reach 90 degrees by the end of the work week, reaching the lower to mid-90s Saturday and Sunday. Over to Canyon City now, you can see daytime temperatures should reach 73 degrees today, 80 tomorrow, 80s the rest of the way on out, but some clearing from those showers and storms to note Friday through Sunday, just like Pueblo. Finally, in Teller County, we'll reach 64 today, 70s by Thursday. Again, a good amount of water to work with the next couple of days. It will start to lighten up on those showers and storms Friday through Sunday, and more widespread storms expected on Monday. So hopefully that helps. And coming up during our Good Morning America cut-ins, I will be breaking down just where we're still seeing some of that fog and also talking about those temperatures, everything you need to know to get you out the door.
Yeah, it may take a while for that fog to burn off, if at all.
It's going to take the next couple of hours at least.
Thanks, Abby.
Now we're going to check in one final time with Paul Richards at KRDO News.